Welcome to this video lecture for HS8151 Communicative English, and in this video lecture we are going to discuss about tenses from Unit 4. So the outcome of this video lecture is the students will be able to differentiate the tenses and use tenses correctly in sentences. So now coming to the topic, tenses. What are tenses? The verbs that indicate the time of occurrence are known as tenses. Tenses indicate the connection between two or more time periods or the exact time an activity occurs. So tenses means the verbs that denote the time. So the duration of the activity can be easily conveyed only through tenses. In tenses, we have three main tenses. So they are the past, present and future. We call it as past tense, present tense and future tense. So the three main tenses are further divided and we get 12 types of tenses. So the present tense is further divided into four types, that is simple present, present continuous, present perfect tense and present perfect continuous tense. Likewise, past tense is subdivided into simple past, past continuous tense, past perfect tense and past perfect continuous tense. So similarly, future tense is subdivided as simple future, future continuous tense, future perfect tense and future perfect continuous tense. So once again, recalling the tenses, the term tense indicates time of action. So there are three main tenses and these tenses are further divided into four. So now let us see a verb, eat, which gets changed according to the time of action. So the variable forms are given here. So if it is in simple present, the verb will be eat or eats. And if it is changed into present continuous, then the verb gets changed as am eating, is eating or are eating. And when it is changed into present perfect, so it gets changed as has eaten or have eaten. And when it is changed into present perfect continuous, the verb will be has been eating or have been eating. So when the verb is in past, that is simple past, it reminds us ate. And when it is in past continuous, it gets changed as was eating or were eating. And for past perfect, so the verb will be in this form, that is had eaten. And for past perfect continuous, the verb changes as had been eating. So for simple future, it will be in shall eat or will eat. And for future continuous, it will be shall be eating or will be eating. And for future perfect, so the verb will be in this form, that is will have been eating. And for future perfect continuous, will have been eating. So now let us see the tenses one by one. And first tense is present tense, that is simple present. So in the simple present, the sentence form will be like subject, then the verb will be used. So the subject may be I, we, you, they, and sometimes it might be he, she, it. So the subject comes before the verb. So if the subject is singular, we add yes to the verb. Okay. And if the subject is plural, we don't add yes. So for example, eat is a verb. Here yes is added if the subject is singular, and we don't add yes if the subject is plural. So for example, he eats a mango. So he is a singular subject, so we are using yes to the verb. And the next example is they eat a mango. So here they is a subject which is plural, so we don't use yes along with the verb. So present tense is usually used in certain situations, for example, for habitual actions, for universal truth, to denote the probable condition, to convey the near future, to express ownership, and to denote the permanent situation, we use a simple present. So to denote the habitual action, for example, you say he goes to college daily. So you are using simple present for habitual action. Then for universal truth also we use a simple present. The sun appears in the east. So this is the universal truth. We use simple present. So if you work hard, you will get distinction. So this is a probable condition given. So we are using simple present. The plane arrives at 9 a.m. So here it conveys the near future. So we are using simple present. And this house belongs to me is used to express the ownership. So here also simple present is used. And to denote a permanent situation like my house faces the east, we use simple present. So here are some keywords that helps to identify whether it is simple present or not. So usually, generally, regularly, commonly, rarely, occasionally, frequently, always, daily, often, every day, every month, every year, once a month, on Mondays. These are all the examples to know whether it is simple present or not. So the next tense is present continuous tense. So the format of this tense is subject plus am, is, are plus verb plus ing. So the subject can be I, we, you and they, and he, she, it. So if it is I, we use am plus verb plus ing, and if it is he, she, it, we use is plus verb plus ing, and if it is you, we and they, we use are plus verb plus ing. So for example, he is eating mangoes. So verb is eat, so ing is added, and he is the singular, so we are writing is. So the next example is they are eating mangoes. So present continuous tense is used to denote an action which is happening at the moment of speaking, and also to denote planned future arrangements. So for example, the children are playing cricket now. So this action is happening at the moment. So we use present continuous tense. And they are planning to go to Ooty next month. So here they have planned for a future arrangement. So we are using present continuous. So present continuous tense is used to denote an action which is happening at the moment of speaking, or to denote the planned future arrangements. And here are some keywords that denotes the present continuous tense. So for example, now, at present, at the moment. So these are the words that denote the action that is happening at the moment. So these words are the keywords for present continuous tense. So the next type is present perfect tense. So present perfect tense is in the form of have or has plus past participle form of the verb. So for example, he has eaten a mango. So here he is a singular subject, so we are using has, and eat is a verb which takes the past participle form. So has eaten a mango, and they have eaten a mango. Here the subject is they, plural, so we are using have eaten. So the helping words that are used for present perfect is have or has. The present perfect tense is used to express an action just completed before, and activity or an experience in the past, an action which began in the past and still continues. So for example, she has finished the work just now. So the work has been finished just now, so we are using present perfect. So has finished. I have been to Bangalore several times. So have been to Bangalore is an experience, so we are using present perfect tense. She has worked here for 5 years. It means she has worked here and she is still working in the. So we are using present perfect tense. So the key words to find the present perfect tense are just now already, just before, after, ever, never, so far, and it. So the next tense that we are going to see is present perfect continuous tense. So present perfect continuous tense is in the form of subject plus has or have plus been plus verb plus ing. So example, he has been eating a mango. So here the subject is singular, so we are using has been eating, and when it is plural we use have been eating. So they have been eating mangoes, so here there's plural, so we are using have been eating mangoes. The present perfect continuous tense is used to denote an action which began in the past, still continues, and may continue in future. For example, the teacher has been working in the school for 10 years. So here, the teacher has already started working in this school and is also working now and will work in the future. So we are using present perfect continuous tense. Another example, they have been studying in this college since 2012. So the students are already studying in this college, now also they are studying and they will study in future also. So we are using present perfect continuous tense. So the keywords to find present perfect continuous tense is for and since. So the next tense that you are going to see is past tense. So here first is simple past. So for example, he ate a mango. They ate mangoes. So in past tense there is no helping verb. The verb remains the same even if the subject is he or she and if it is plural. So to denote the definite past we use past tense. To denote improbable condition also we use past tense. And to denote the past habitual action also we use simple past. And if an action that took place regularly in the past also, we use simple past. For example, I completed my project last week. So the project was completed earlier, so we are using simple past. If you came earlier, you would catch the train. So to denote the improbable condition, we use simple past. And I used to play in the evening when I was young. So to denote the past habitual action also we use simple past. And in the sentence, used to utilize the past habitual action. So she exercised every morning before going out. So exercising is a habit that took place regularly in the past. So we are using simple past. So the key words to find the simple past are yesterday, last week, last month, last year, etc. So the next tense is past continuous tense. So past continuous tense is in the format subject plus was verb plus ing, otherwise subject plus were plus verb plus ing. Example, he was eating a mango. So here the subject is singular he, so we are using was eating. And in this sentence, they were eating mangoes. They is a plural subject, so we are using were eating. So past continuous tense is used to denote the past continuous action. And if two action occurred at the same time but one action was already in progress, then we use past continuous tense. Example, the baby was crying at night. So was crying, because crying was a past continuous action, so we are using past continuous tense. And for example, I was watching TV when my uncle came to my house. So in the sentence, two actions are there and the one was already in progress when the next action occurs. So I was watching TV, and while I was watching TV, my uncle has come. So here, to express that this action was already in progress, we use past continuous tense. Another example is, while he was going to college, he met with an accident. So he was going to the college and at that time he met with an accident. So the action that was already in progress is mentioned by past continuous tense. So the key words to identify past continuous tense is when and while. So the next tense is past perfect tense. So past perfect tense is in the format subject plus had plus past participle form of the verb. So example, he had eaten a mango. So another example is they had eaten mangoes. So even if the subject is singular or plural, the verb remains the same. So when two actions occurred in the past, the action occurred before another action carries the past perfect form of the verb. Likewise, the past perfect form is used in impossible conditions. So some examples. Before I went to the railway station, the train had left. So in the sentence, two actions have happened in the past. One is I went to the railway station, and the another is train had left. So in order to denote that this action had happened in the first, we use past perfect form of the verb. So the train had left, it is the first action that had happened. So we are using the past perfect form of the verb to denote that. So another example is, after she had completed her homework, she went to bed. So in the sentences also, two actions had happened in the past. One is she had completed her homework, and another is she went to bed. So here, she completed her homework first. So in order to say that this is the first action that had happened, we are using past perfect form of the verb. So another example is, if she had danced well, she would have won the prize. So this is an imaginary condition. So in order to say that it is an impossible condition, we use past perfect form of the verb. So we are using, she had danced well. If she had danced well, she would have won the prize. So actually, she had not won any prizes, but if she had danced well, she would have won the prize. So in order to say that it is an impossible condition, we use past perfect tense. So the key words to identify past perfect tense is after and before. And the helping verb used in past perfect verb is had. The next tense is past perfect continuous tense. So past perfect continuous tense is in the form subject plus had plus been plus verb plus ing. So example, he had been eating a mango. They had been eating mangoes. So even if the subject is singular or plural, the verb remains the same. Had been eating. So to show an action which began in the past before a certain point and continued up to that. So to indicate that, we use past perfect continuous tense. So for example, the baby had been crying before she saw her mother. So the baby was crying till her mother saw her, and it was a continuous process. So we are using past perfect continuous. So now let us get into future tense. The first thing is simple future. So simple future is in the form of subject plus shall or will plus present verb. So example, he will eat a mango. They will eat mangoes. So even if the subject is singular or plural, the verb remains the same. Will eat. So to express an action which will happen in the future, we use simple future tense. So to express willingness to do something also, we use simple future tense. And to express a decision made at the time of speaking also, we use simple future tense. So again, simple future tense is used in questions tags as well. So here are some examples. The first one is, he will return from the UK tomorrow. So in order to express that this action will happen in future, we use simple future. I will help you. So I am willingly helping you. So we use simple future tense. I will call on you in a short while. So to express a decision that is made at the time of speaking, we use simple future. And let us leave this place, shall we? So in order to use question tags, we use simple future. The key words to identify simple future are tomorrow, next week, next month, next year in 2022. The modal verbs used in future tense is shall or will. So the next tense is future continuous tense. So a future continuous tense will be in the form at subject plus shall be plus verb ing or will be plus verb ing. For example, he will be eating a mango, they will be eating mangoes. So even if the subject is singular or plural, the verb remains the same, will be eating. The helping verb is shall be or will be. So to express continuing action in future, we use future continuous tense. For example, I will be preparing for the semester exam this time next month. The key words to find out future continuous tense is this time tomorrow, this time next week, this time next year. So the next tense is future perfect tense. Future perfect tense is in the format subject plus shall or will plus have plus past participle form of the verb. So shall have and will have is a helping verb used. So example is, he will have eaten a mango, they will have eaten mangoes. So in order to say that an action which will be completed before a particular time in future, we use future perfect tense. So example, she will have completed her project by next week. So the key words used in future perfect tense are by, within, so the next tense is future perfect continuous tense. So future perfect continuous tense is in the format subject plus shall or will plus have plus been plus verb plus ing. So example is, he will have been eating a mango. So will have been eating is the format for future perfect continuous tense. They will have been eating mangoes. So in order to express an action that will be in progress over a period of time, so we use future perfect continuous tense. So to indicate the duration. So example, he will have been working in this college for 7 years by next June. So 7 years by next June is the calculation that they had made. So we are using future perfect continuous tense to denote an action that will be in progress over. So now let us get into the exercises. And the first one is simple present tense. So stop the video, do the exercise, and then watch the answers. He used to visit us every week, but he rarely comes now. Abdul wants to be a doctor. The soup tastes good. He watches TV every evening. She goes to college by college bus every day. So next exercise is from present continuous tense. It is raining, so we can't go to the beach now. He is doing his MBA from the Emerson University. Someone is listening to our conversation. The boys are playing cricket now. At present, the students are listening to the lecture. So the next tense is present perfect tense. I have completed the work just before. I have booked the tickets already. He has come here just now. So the next one is present perfect continuous tense, and here we are using have been or has been. So first one is, I have been waiting for my girlfriend for 2 hours. He has been living in Yase since last 5 years. He has been working in this institution since 2012. So the next tense is simple past tense. I wanted to visit you yesterday, but you were not at home. We went to Guwahati by Rajdhani Express last month. The journey was cool. It imparted solace to the soul and mind. Last week, I visited the trade fair. I saw a wonderful film in the cinema last night. So the next one is past continuous tense. So first question, we were watching TV when it started to rain. Second one is, while the teacher was examining Mr. Jones this morning, his son was waiting outside. The sun was shining when the climber reached Mount Everest. When I left the house this morning, it was raining. Everyone was sleeping when the earthquake hit the small town. So the next one is past perfect tense. So first question, after Ram had seen the film on TV, he decided to buy the book. Before I went to my friend's house, he had already left home. Before the police arrived, the robbers had already escaped. So the next one is future tense. So first question is, I hope that you will meet me soon. So second question, when I will be 60 years old, I will open a club. And the third question is, the plane will take off in a few minutes. So now it is future perfect tense. So first question is, I predict that by 2020, man will have landed on Mars. So second question is, she will have submitted the project by next Monday. And the final question is, he will have finished the work within 2 hours. So here is an exercise that you need to solve. And this exercise questions has all the tenses within it. And you can check yourself by answering this exercise and know how much you have learned from tenses. So finally coming to university questions. So try to solve these questions and make use of these questions. So that's all for this video lecture. And thank you so much for listening. So keep practicing so many sentences. Keep loving learning till the end.